I thought LaVar was brilliant when he had Lonzo wearing all those different brands in the summer league. It generated all that press. I thought it would change the way players receive sponsorship deals as we know it. Well, none of those shoe companies chose to bite. And I think Lonzo is going to be fine, but since then, LiAngelo was thrown in a Chinese jail for shoplifting. LaVar pulled him out of UCLA. He said LaMelo is no longer going to play in college, so they can both go play in Lithuania for less than the food stipend they would have received at UCLA. And now, apparently, LaVar wants to start his own pro league for players fresh out of high school that don't want to go to college. The league would pay the lowest ranked players a salary of $3,000 a month and the highest $10,000 a month, and the league would follow NBA rules. Look, I'm not a big fan of the one-and-done system, but there's a reason a pro league like this hasn't come to fruition. LaVar Ball isn't the first person to come up with this idea, because it seems like a good idea. The truth is, the system that's currently in place, if players don't want to go to college, they can go to Europe for a year and get paid. But most choose not to do that because although they're not being paid, even though some are definitely being paid, the year of free marketing at UCLA, Duke, Kansas, or UNC is still extremely valuable. And in the scheme of things, 1 year of college ball is not that big of a commitment. Again, plenty of people have come up with the idea of a pro league for kids out of high school, but there's a reason nobody has actually followed through with it. And it's no coincidence LaVar just magically wanted to start a pro league after his sons were no longer NCAA eligible. Starting a professional basketball league is not the same as running a shoe and t-shirt company out of your garage. I don't care what your brand awareness is. If Nike could have started their own pro league, they would have done it years ago. Okay, that's it for this episode of The Sideline Dissident. I'll be back tomorrow. Until then, I bid you adieu.